Hello everyone, myself Dr. Jyoti Gangurde, Assistant Professor of Zoology, KTHM College Nasik. Students, we are continuing with the chapter Sound Producing Organs of Insect, and here we are continuing with the topic Sound Producing Organs of Insect. So in previous lecture we already discussed regarding the elateral methods of sound producing as a sound producing organs. Along with that, the another method, that is electrophemeral method. Okay, now today we are going to discuss on the thimble mechanism. Okay, so the first mechanism is a stridulatory or frictional mechanism, in which we discuss the stridulatory organs. Then again the what is the electoral method, and again electrophemeral method. Now we continue with the next part of the sound producing organ of insect, is the thimble mechanism. Now the thimble organs are well developed in some Hemiptera and in Lepidoptera. Okay, means specifically they are developed in case of bugs or in case of moths as well as butterflies. Now here the thimble organs, they are highly evolved in Hemiptera, particularly in Eukinorhynchus and Cicadas. Now pentatomids among Hemiptera and in Articidae, and in case of again particularly Lepidoptera, or we focused on the moths. Okay, now in those insects, such a thimble mechanism, which is a common process of sound producing or common organs, they produce a particular kind of sound. Now here the thimble organs, so here the thimble organs in Hemipteras or either Cicadas, here they are well developed in males as a pair of membranous structures on dorsal region of first abdominal segment. Okay, now here such a thimble organs, particularly they are, in case suppose we are taking example of Hemiptera, so particularly in Cicada, such a thimble organ which is well developed in male as a pair of membranous structures on the dorsolateral regions of the first abdominal segments, whereas such a thimble, it is a chitinous membrane. Okay, so thimble, it is a chitinous membrane, or it is made up of a chitinous material. So it is supported by around its edges by a strong chitinous ring. Okay, and it is a strong chitinous ring and normally board shape, means you can see in the diagram it is board shape outside. Now the thimble muscle is attached to the thimble at the center. Okay, now internally it is communicated with an air sac which opens through the spiracles. Now in Lepidoptera, example Melisi or Melisi Cloudomia, where the organs are paired structures situated on lateral side of the metathorax. So in case of Lepidoptera, such a Melisi, here the such organs, they are located at the lateral side of the metathorax. Now the modified cataepisternum of the metathorax, which is swollen outward and sclerotized. Now there are striations about 10 to 60 in number towards the anterior end of the thimble. Now here the metathoracic basilar muscle is which is an accuting muscle. Okay, now in case of Heliothis zia, so this is the moth, or particularity of this moth is here shows a presence of large number of micro thimbles. Okay, now in case of Heliothis zia, here such a kind of moth which having a particular or peculiarity, that such a micro timbers they are present, and here such a timbal organs of these moths, they are well known to produce ultrasonic signals to confuse the bats. Okay. Now, so here in case of such a Heliothisia, okay, which reported a number of such a timbals, okay, presence of number of timbals to form collectively a timbal organ, and now which produce a particular kind of sound, but here which produce a sound or which gives a ultrasonic signal, and such a signals they confuse their enemies, or the enemies they are nothing but the bats. Okay, now focused on the mechanism. So the mechanism here, when the tibial muscle is contracted, okay, the timbal is pulled inward, and a consequent distortion of timbal membrane produces a pulse of sound. Okay, here you can also focus on the diagram. You can also focus on this diagram. Here you can see this is the region of the thorax where mesothoracic segment, where the mesothoracic legs are present. Here you can see this is the attachment, or here you can see the coxa which is fixed into the coxal cavity, coxa which is supported by a small structure which is nothing but the trochanter which connects the femur and coxa. Here you can see this is the femur region of the insect leg, and particularly here you can see at the femur region such a timbals they are reported. Okay, now here you can see the striated bands, they are present. Now here you can see the timbals are present, or which collectively form such a timbal organ. Here you can see again this is the catasternum. Here anapisternum. Here again this is the abdominal region. Here the epimeron, this is here the meron, and here the part of timbal which covered in scales, and here this is the basilla. Okay, so this is the structure of timbal organ in case of the Lepidopteran moth, that is Malassezii. Now again come to the mechanism. Here the mechanism such as when the timbal muscle is contracted, the timbal is pulled inward, and a consequent distortion of timbal membrane produce a pulse of sound. So with the relaxation, okay, in first step is what, contraction takes place, and due to contraction the timbal which is pulled, and distortion of such a timbal membrane which produces a pulse of sound. Now after the second step, with the relaxation of timbal muscle, okay, a timbal springs back to its original position due to its elasticity, and it again produces another pulse of sound. Okay, so continuously the contraction relaxation procedure which is going on, and by this way the sound which is produced, okay, continuous sound which is produced. Now the two timbals work synchronously. Okay, so the two timbals, they work synchronously. Here the frequency of the sound which is about 390 to 4500 cycles per second. Okay, now this is the parameter where we can count the frequency of the sound which is produced by such a timbal organs, or the organs of sound producing organs of insect here, which is near about 390 to 4500 cycles per second. Okay, now you can again observe this structure. So this is about the second type, that is the timbal mechanism. Now it is followed by the next, that is epipharyngeal mechanism. Okay, so the first is what, the frictional mechanism, second one is the timbal, and third one is the epipharyngeal mechanism. Now in epipharyngeal mechanism, which is found in date hedgehog moth. Okay, particularly which is found in the Dutch hedgehog moth, and again here which is found in Acherontia atropis. Okay, now here the epipharyngeal apparatus, the proboscis acting as an amplifier, the pharynx which is an ear pump, and the epipharynx is or as a vibrating instrument. Okay, now the pharyngeal muscles operate the ear pump or which operate the pharynx. Okay, so here the particular epipharyngeal apparatus, they produces a particular kind of sound. Okay, this is the third mechanism. By using epipharyngeal apparatus, the insects, they produce sound. Okay, here again the proboscis which is acting as an amplifier, which amplify the frequency of sound, whereas the pharynx which is acting as an air pump, and epipharynx which is acting as a vibrating instrument. Okay, now here the pharyngeal muscles, they operate the air pump. Okay, or the pharynx, the muscles of pharynx, they operate the process by using its muscles. Okay, come to the mechanism of epipharyngeal mechanism of, here you can see epipharyngeal mechanism, and you can focus on this diagram how the mechanism is here. Now the contraction of pharyngeal muscles induces dilation of the pharynx, and the air is sucked through the proboscis. Okay, now it causes the epipharynx to vibrate, and a sound is produced by a pulse of air stream. Here the relaxation of pharyngeal muscle induces the contraction of pharynx, and air is blown out. Now the exhalant air stream, which also produces a high pitched sound like the whistle, or during which the epipharynx is held erect. Okay, now here the steps are there. This is the first step, and here you can see the mechanism. Here you can see after relaxation such a proboscis which is straight. Okay, now we can focus on this diagram. So here the pharyngeal muscles, they are present. This is the pharyngeal or the pharynx region. Here you can see the epipharynx. This is the esophagus, your salivary glands, and this is the proboscis. So usually in case of this dead hedgehog or hawk moths, here moth or which belongs to order Lepidoptera, and that's why the moth which constitute the mouth part such as the siphoning type of mouth part. Now here you can see this is nothing but the siphon, or this is what we commonly called as a proboscis. Okay, so this is the proboscis. Usually the proboscis which is at resting stage, which is in the form of coil structure. Now why the feeding process such a coil structure which become uncoiled? Here again the mechanism is what? The contraction of pharyngeal muscle. Okay, the contraction of pharyngeal muscle which induces the dilation of pharynx, and the air is sucked through the proboscis. Here the air which is sucked through the proboscis, so it causes the epipharynx to vibrate. Okay, which causes, suppose the outside of air which is taken by the proboscis, so due to the intake of air, the epipharynx which vibrate, and the sound is produced by a pulse of air stream. Now this is because of the contraction of the pharyngeal muscle. Now the relaxation of pharyngeal muscle, okay, which induces the contraction of pharynx, and the air is blown out. Now the exhalant air stream also produces a high pitched sound like again whistle, or during which the epipharynx is held erect. Okay, when the whistle sound is produced, that time such a epipharynx, okay, the epipharynx which held erect. Okay, now here you can see this is the first step. Now again this is the pharyngeal cavity which pulsed air stream, and here the epipharynx, due to the Air which is taken by the proboscis, here you can see the epipharynx which vibrates and produces a particular sound, okay, or a air stream. And in next step, after contraction of such a pharynx, okay, the air is blown out and the exhalant air stream produces a high pitch sound like the whistle. Okay, here you can see the erect of the epipharynx. So due to erect, which produces a particular whistle like sound. Okay, now the sound production which is possible only if the pharynx is empty. Now, due to vibration of epipharynx, the sound of frequency which is near about, the frequency of sound which is near about 280 cycles per second, okay, which is produced. Now, in case of such a moth, okay, such a dead head hawk moth, here particularly the sound which is produced near about 280 cycles per second. Now, this is what the third mechanism, third type of mechanism, that is epipharyngeal mechanism, by which again the insect which produce a particular kind of sound. Now, come to the characteristic of sounds. Okay, so characteristics of insect sound. Now, here man which can hear sound of some orthopteran species, that of acridids, from a distance of again 1 or 2 meters, then again that is Limobius, which is we can hear the sound from 8 meters, or again Teptigonia, we can hear the sound near about 100 meters, and that of Gryllotalpa, we can hear the sound the distance that is near about 350 meters. Okay, now the stridulatory apparatus through a single to and fro movement may produce a single or series of pulses. Okay, so by using such a stridulatory mechanism, either a single or series of sound pulses they produces. Now, the pulses show a unique sequence called a phrase. Now, the sound may, which is therefore a continuous or discontinuous with silent intervals. Means, suppose the pulse which is continuous, that time the sound is continuous. Suppose the pulse is not continuous, or it is, suppose the gap is present from world in between the one or former and latter pulse, that time the sound which is the discontinuous sound. Okay, now such a pulse, they can be defined as a discrete or discontinuous trail of sound waves. Now, here the different frequencies of sounds they are mentioned. Here the frequency of a sound is species specific. Okay, now that is constant in a particular species. Now, the frequency of sound produced by some species of insect which is mentioned here. Suppose in case of honeybee or apis, the mechanism is wing beating mechanism, and we show the frequency, that is 250 cycles per second. Now, in case of mosquito and culex, again the mechanism is wing beating, and we show the frequency, that is 280 to 350 cycles per second. Now, in case of locust or cystocera, this shows the mechanism by using flight, and they shows the frequency such as in between 60 to 6400 cycles per second. Now, in case of termites or zootermes or grasshoppers, they shows the tapping mechanism, tapping to the substrata, or they shows the frequency of sound near about 1000 cycles per second. Now, in case of here epiphagor, here we shows the stridulation mechanism and produces the frequency of sound, that is 5 to 100 kilo cycles per second. Now, again Stenobothrus, or this shows same, that is stridulation, or in case of cricket and Gryllus, same. Now, this shows the frequency near about 2 to 50 kilocycles per second, whereas the second one, that is 2 to 8 kilocycles per second. Now, in case of cicada or cicaca, this shows the mechanism, that is timbal, and the frequency, that is in between 2 to 6 kilocycles per second. Now, in case of moths and malacy, again we shows the mechanism. Okay, here we discuss the mechanism, that is we shows the timbal mechanism and the frequency of sound, which is near about 11 to 160 kilocycles per second. Now again, in case of moths and again acherontia, okay, which produce the sound by means of epipharyngeal mechanism, and the frequency of sound, which is near about 280 cycles per second. Okay, now this is what the characteristic of sound which is produced by different insects. So, here the characteristic of sound of insect which is species specific. Okay, now we can focus on the last topic of this chapter, classification and significance of sound. Now, here the classification and significance of sound, which is here, which is defined as a frequency of the sound or the frequency of sound of species which is varies in its characteristic mostly due to the pulse repetition frequency. So, due to the pulse repetition frequency, here the sound which can be classified. Now, the oscillograms of the sound produced at different conditions by some orthopteroid insects show that each species produced a number of different sounds having a specific biological significance. That I already told you, the sound production of sound which is a which having a biological significance, such as aggregations for mating, or again if the insects, they suffer from danger. Okay, so they have biological significance. Now, on the basis of oscillogram, the functional specificity, here the insect songs are classified by Alexander in 1967 into various types. Okay, so here the mechanism of sound production and reception, okay, which is, okay, Alexander, which mentions the various types, such as calling song, then aggressive song, courtship song, and warning song, copulatory song, post copulatory song, and recognition song. Okay, so these are the types of such a sounds. The types such as calling song, aggressive song, courtship song, warning song, then copulatory song, post copulatory song, and recognition song. Okay, now here the mechanism of sound production and repeat reception, which is well established in Orthoptera, Hemiptera, Coleoptera, and Diptera. Now, the sounds are used in promoting mating, process of mating, then courtship and copulation among the opposite sexes. Now, which exhibiting a unique acoustic signaling as a integral part of reproductive behavior. Now, the acoustic signals in reproductive behavior are initiated with the calling song in order to bring the opposite sexes together, and then followed by courtship, copulatory, and post copulatory signals in a vain planned fashion. The acoustic signals, again, they are species specific and perhaps integrated with the extrinsic as well as intrinsic factors influencing either directly or indirectly. Now, the reproductive physiology and behavior of insects. So, this is what the reproductive physiology and behavior of insect. Now, acoustic behavior, which is also found in verily in riverly or territorially adapted Orthoptera and in social termites, such as zootermopsis. Now, in case of ants and in case of bees. Now, which is involved in reproductive, defensive and in various purposes, forming a sort of an operative acoustic communication system in the social insects. Now, in here, Arctid and Tenochid moths, the sound is used as an acoustic mimicry like bats. Okay. Now, means they are using the sound for their protection. Okay, now this is again what about all the sound producing organs in case of insect. Again, the sound which is produced by insect having a biological significance, and such a sound which is produced by insect which is species specific. Okay, now in next lecture we discuss regarding the light producing organs of insect. Okay, so thank you so much.